Good morning, students. Today I am going to teach Standard 7 History, Chapter 1, Medieval Europe, Rise and Spread of Christianity. History, as we study today, is generally divided into three periods: the ancient or early period, medieval or middle period, and modern period. So, in this chapter, we are going to learn about medieval period. The period between the ancient and the modern period is known as the medieval period. The word medieval is derived from a Latin word medium erum, which means time in the middle. The medieval period lies roughly between the 8th and the 18th century CE. CE means the birth of Jesus Christ marked the beginning of a new era called the Christian era. An important event in medieval period was the growth and spread of Christianity. However, let us first study about the birth of this religion, that is Christianity. Religious beliefs. Within the Roman Empire, there were many religious beliefs. Rome tolerated different religions as long as citizens worshipped Roman gods too, including the emperor. Because most people believe in more than one God. This did not cause a problem for a long time. Later, however, a division arose among the Jews. The Jews, they had internal fights. In this turbulent, Jesus, the founder of Christianity, was born. Now, let us learn about early life of Jesus. Jesus was born to a couple named Joseph and Mary in Bethlehem in Judea in 6th century. Jesus grew up in the town of Nazareth. It is believed that just before his birth, Mary was visited by an angel who told her that she would have a son who would be blessed. Christians believe that Jesus was the blessed one and he is the Son of God. By the age of 30, Jesus began to travel from village to village, spreading his message among the people. He told everyone short stories and parables. What are parables? Short stories told by Jesus Christ. That taught the values of life and love for God and mankind. Jesus attracted many followers through his teachings and miracles. Miracles such as healing the sick, feeding an entire crowd, he cured the blind and lepers. Then Jesus also began healing many people who suffered from physical disabilities. People thronged to him for experiencing his healing touch and to listen to his wise words. Means people used to go to him to listen to him, to have his healing touch and to listen to his kind words. There were four gospels widely in use today, which are the four books of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. This first four books of the New Testament tells the story of Jesus Christ, about his life and his teachings. Now let us study about his teachings. Jesus' main message was that of love. It means that he said, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, means you bless them, those who harm you. His message was to love your neighbor as long as you love yourself. Then one must hate the sin and not the sinner. Sin means something which is against God, and sinner means someone who has done something wrong according to religious or moral law. Then the next point is crucifixion. Jesus attracted many followers, but because of his increasing popularity, political and religious leaders viewed him as a threat. That is why Jesus was accused of false charges. The Roman Emperor Pontius Pilate sentenced Jesus to death. Jesus was crucified. Crucified means it is a type of execution in which a person is nailed to cross. Jesus was crucified on Friday, which came to be known as Good Friday. On the third day of his crucifixion, his disciples found that his tomb is empty. He was not there. His body was not there. They believed as God, he rose from the dead. The Christians celebrate this day as the Easter. After his crucifixion in Golgotha in 30 CE, the cross became the sacred symbol for Christians. But after his death also, Christianity did not decline but gained popularity. How? Jesus, he had chosen 12 disciples called the apostles. Apostles means they were the followers of Jesus who helped him in spreading the ideas or his teachings. Now let us see how Christianity spreads. As Christianity spread, it faced many problems. However, this changed with the conversion of the Roman Empire Emperor Constantine to Christian faith. Means he has started believing in Christianity. The capital was shifted from Rome to Constantinople. Christianity continued to spread throughout the Roman world. Towards the end of the 4th century, what happened? Christianity, it became the official religion of the Roman Empire. Constantine got many monasteries and churches constructed. The Christian monks, they used to spread Christianity to almost whole of Europe, then Great Britain, Switzerland, Germany, and also in other countries. Saint Peter's Church in Rome, it became the religious headquarters, and the Pope, he became the spiritual head of the Christians all over the world. Who? The Pope. Now, decline of the Roman Empire. In In 395 CE, the Roman Empire was divided in two parts, that is, Eastern and Western. The Western Empire had fallen about in 476 CE. But in the East, however, the Roman Empire continued in the form of Byzantine Empire. And its capital was Constantinople. The Roman Empire was suffering a setback due to the repeated inventions of non-Christian tribes. Who were they? Goths, Huns, Franks, and Vandals. This tribe continued to attack for a long period of time. And ultimately what happened? Finally, they were responsible for the collapse of Roman Empire. Then the Crusades. In the 11th century CE, the Turks, they attacked the ruler of Constantinople. Why? Because they wanted to reoccupy the Holy Land. So as a result, many wars were fought between Pope Urban II and Turkish Muslims. These war is known as your Crusades. The Crusades were crucial event in the history of Christianity. There were 8 Crusades which resulted in the recapture of Jerusalem. So, in spite of holding Jerusalem for nearly a century and for gaining some other strongholds in the east, the Crusades, they were failed to establish a permanent Christian kingdoms in the Holy Land. Now, why? Because somehow the Turks were still powerful. Now, let us learn some of the consequences of the Crusades. So, after fighting for around 200 years, what is the result of the Crusades? The Crusades brought about many important changes. The Crusades, in the course of their expeditions, means the Crusades, whenever they were going out for war, they used to come in contact with the Greek culture. And now who used to follow the Greek culture? The Turk. The Turk. They used to follow the Greek culture. So, these Crusades, what they used to do? They started acquiring knowledge of this civilization, that is your Greek culture. So, as a result, there was improvement in medicine and architecture. Then there was increase in trade. The economy of Europe flourished. Many new towns and cities established. And also the authority of king has increased. Now let us learn about monasteries and their impact. Monasteries, they provide shelter to travelers and food and clothing to the poor. Nuns, they used to educate the children and treated the sick and the wounded. Monasteries became centers of learning. Some of the monasteries later developed into famous universities such as University of Oxford and the University of Cambridge. Monasteries were responsible for the spread of Christianity to other regions. How? Because monks, they used to spread the message of Jesus Christ. So with this, I come to the end of the chapter, and I want you to go through the chapter properly and learn the key terms. And very soon, I am going to upload my next video where I am going to give you short questions and answers, and also the long questions. Thank you.